up? I'm JD the Diva. And have you ever considered, what do I want to be when I grow up? Well, you don't have to ask that question anymore. Central Piedmont Community College is where you need to be. They have everything you need. If you're considering a different skill, if you want to boost your trade, upscale a little bit to make some more money, this is the place for you. Speaking of money, you don't know how you're going to pay for it? Well, they do have phenomenal scholarship programs here. Today, we'll talk about making it financially possible here at Central Piedmont. So now we're getting down to the nitty gritty, the money part of it. And I'm standing here right now inside Central Piedmont talking to Desiree Patterson. And how you doing, Desiree?
I'm doing well. How are you?
I'm excited to talk to you about how students can financially make this possible for them. The money, honey. That's what I'm talking about. So let's talk a bit about that process. Is it grueling? Because I know sometimes when you talk about scholarship programs, it can get, you know, too in-depth, too detailed. What is the process like here at Central Piedmont?
We try to make it very easy for all of our students. So we have a scholarship portal that only has you apply for one application. So it's just one application will apply you for all of our opportunities. Over 250 opportunities to be awarded here. So just filling out that one application, those 20 questions, two very short essays just about yourself, and then you're in the money.
Things you already know, obviously.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. So have you seen how that has impacted students here?
Yes, very much so. I currently facilitate a scholarship program through the Presidential Scholars Program. And so I'm able to interact one-on-one with those students who receive scholarships. So I've definitely seen the impact it has on their studies, how less stressed they are, because now they don't have to work multiple jobs in order to pay for school. So they're able to really put in their time into the academics. Mm-hmm. And then seeing them transfer off, just being a better student, knowing that they didn't have to go through that process or that painful stress process of paying for college has been awesome.
And so is it fully covering tuition or it varies?
It varies. Our minimum scholarship amount is $500, but most of our scholarships do go up to full tuition, which we value at $3,200 per year.
Wow. Okay. So it's as simple as
1, 2, 3, for real. Really is 1, 2, 3. One application, 20 short questions, all about yourself. And then you're applied for over, again, 200 opportunities.
So let's go change some lives here at Central Piedmont.
Coming to you live from, no, I'm just playing. How y'all doing, man? I'm Burpie from No Limit Larry in the morning Maddhouse on Power 98, but I'm not here at Central Piedmont by myself. I got my partner with me.
Thanks for the invite. We are so happy to be here. My name is Maney from the Maney, Roy, and Lorraine Morning Show on KISS 95.1. We are so fortunate to be joined by four fantastic people who are going to help us answer some listener questions today.
Yes, they are, but we're not going to let them answer those questions until they introduce themselves. How y'all doing?
Doing well. I am Desiree Patterson. I am the scholarship coordinator with Central Piedmont Foundation.
Hi, I'm Dr. Estrada. I'm in the outreach and recruitment department. I'm a recruiter and I also recruit Latino students.
Hello, I am April Atkinson. I am a recent graduate of Central Piedmont and I just received my associate's in applied science.
Hello, I'm Sydney Poindexter and I'm a student of part of the Presidential Scholarship Program.
Thank you all for being here with Maney and myself. We appreciate y'all. Every single one of y'all for being here. We had some listeners from KISS 95.1, from Power 98, and from V101.9. They submitted questions that they would like to know from you all. First question that I have, we would like for you all to tell us about financial aid and scholarship programs here at Central Piedmont. And how does it work and how can someone qualify?
So I, again, am the scholarship coordinator. So the way our financial aid works is that you would want to complete the FAFSA. It is the free application for federal student aid. And it, again, is a free application. There are a lot of scams online that have you pay to complete the FAFSA. You do not have to pay to complete the FAFSA. So that free application is going to be sent off to the state as well as just to the federal government to let you know what type of federal grants and scholarships that you could qualify for. Separately, you would then also want to complete the Central Piedmont Scholarship application. And that application is very short, 20 questions, two short essays, just all about what you want to do with your life. How do you see your this degree or program factoring into what you want to do in the future? Those short 20 questions, and that will qualify you for over 300 plus donor opportunities that we have here at Central Piedmont. In regards to the FAFSA, there are a lot of different things that vary based on what you could qualify for. A lot of it is based on income and need. Our scholarships are based on your program, can be based on your GPA, and can also be based on whatever income or need that you have to attend here.
So if you do want to get into the pipeline to be how would I say, to be a part of a consideration for a scholarship, you can log on to www.cpcc.edu/afford. It's a small questionnaire. It'll put you right into the pipeline. So that way you can be contacted as to what type of scholarship would best fit you or suit you. So again, www.cpcc.edu/afford.
My situation, I actually didn't receive any money from FAFSA. So luckily, my high school advisors were definitely pushing me to apply to as many scholarships as possible. So definitely for anyone who, you know, who doesn't receive any kind of FAFSA, to definitely take a look, like they said, at the scholarships that are available from CPCC. That way you can definitely make sure you're getting some type of money to help you pay for school so that, you know, you're not definitely paying straight out of pocket. So that's also very important.
Just to follow up on that, are there limits as to the amount someone can get from these awards?
In regards to scholarships, we do up to full tuition, and most time that is valued at $3,200 per academic year. So $1,600, and that usually cover per semester to cover books, tuition, and fees. And that's on average for students not needing to pay no more than that. There are limits on Pell eligibility and what you can receive from the FAFSA. And again, that is all based on your income and tax information from you and your parents as you're filling out that FAFSA.
Are these programs similar to the traditional FAFSA programs where someone is judged by income or other factors?
Again, other factors can be included, and I'll let Sydney respond to about how she didn't necessarily qualify for FAFSA, but she was able to receive a scholarship just based on GPA, based on her essays and her responses to that application.
So unfortunately, I wasn't able to receive any type of FAFSA. So I definitely had to apply for the general scholarships for CP. And so definitely having good test scores from high school, so SATs, all of those good GPAs definitely allowed me to kind of put myself in a better position to receive more of a scholarship. So that definitely helped with me being able to attend.
And also, students who have a bachelor's degree may not qualify for financial aid, and so they can still apply for the scholarship opportunities that are available here at Central Piedmont, because that doesn't necessarily meet into the requirements.
A lot of students think that, oh, to apply for a scholarship, or the only way that I get a scholarship is if I'm a graduating high school senior. No, you can be a continuing student and you can apply for that scholarship. So I thought about that when you said, you know, if you already have a bachelor's, a lot of students will feel defeated and say, oh, well, I have to pay for it outright. No, you can still be a part of being able to secure some type of funding. Even we have a very unique program called Student Ambassadors Program, where we select about 12 students, and those 12 students, some, they work for us. They conduct tours, they make calls, and in return, and they do events, and in return, we pay for your tuition in full. So that's just another way.
Just to piggyback off of that question, for the students, for the recent graduate and for the current student now, how is that? How are the programs, the scholarship programs, and the money that you can get from Central Piedmont, how is that financially beneficial to you?
So I had the opportunity to participate in the Ruth G. Shaw Leadership Program. She was actually the first female president of Central Piedmont. So that, along with that, was a scholarship that definitely helped with my tuition. And I met amazing women in all different fields all over the city. And that's contributed to my current career right now.
So I would definitely say it's been very beneficial, especially not having to, you know, pay out of pocket for sure. And also being able to still, like they said, the previous panel, being able to still have the work balance life. So, you know, not really having to struggle with trying to make sure I'm making ends meet to pay for school. It's definitely been, you know, great benefits from it. And so I'm very, you know, thankful.
So here's a question I have. As a student once myself and a college student, I often felt like it was the smarter people than me that were getting these scholarships. Is there a certain GPA that you have to have? Is there a certain student that Central Piedmont looks at to get these scholarships?
All of our scholarship programs vary, so we can go as low as a 2.0 GPA for some of our scholarship opportunities. So some of our students who may be coming out of high school didn't do so well in high school. If you have at least a 2.0, you might be able to qualify for some of our scholarship programs. Our bare minimum, we usually typically look at 2.5, but there are specific ones that go down to that 2.0. So it definitely varies for the student and for whatever the donor stipulation requirement was.
That's beneficial.
Yeah, because that could be a roadblock for
right,
a lot of people.
Right, right. A lot of people might think, oh, I don't have the grades to get the... Right. And they might not even try to apply.
They might not try.
That was a great question, Maney. Thanks, great question. So are there scholarship programs available for all adult learning programs that are offered here, or are they just specific degrees or certification?
It is both. So it is all, pretty much all programs that are offered here, we have a scholarship opportunity for. One thing to bring up, especially when thinking of adult learners, would be that that accelerated career training program. And they are very short term certifications that you can get to go right into a job. And those are fully scholarshiped opportunities, as well as our Bridges to Careers program, which has just been recently partnered with Bank of America. Again, working with students who are in specific IT, healthcare, construction, things like that, and fully scholarshiping them throughout those 2 years in order to for them to be placed into a job. So it varies, again, between the students and the programs that are offered. But if you're looking for a scholarship, we have a scholarship for you.
So the last question I have is kind of an all-encompassing question. There's a lot of excuses that you guys, students, you guys know can make to not go to school, not go to college, not to further your education. But what we've learned, Burp, is that Central Piedmont makes it really easy for you to get in and to start getting those classes. Whether you're a full-time parent with a full-time job, there's something here for you. So someone who is listening to our conversation right now, and you're watching me right now, this question is for you. What would you tell someone who was thinking, I don't want to incur a huge bill, I don't have time to get in, I got my life, I got my kids? Let's go over that again, like how easy it is, or how easy it can be for someone like that to get into Central Piedmont and to start forwarding their career and their life scholastically.
So I'm an entrepreneur in the beauty industry for the last 15 years or so, definitely an adult learner, but decided to further my education. And once I started and maintained a great GPA, I was able to get scholarships. I definitely feel like once you're a student here, the college will do anything to make sure that you stay and that you finish. And anytime you have any issues and you mention it, they find ways to help you finish strong.
I definitely would have to agree with that. Also, you know, if you are, you know, pretty busy, they do have part-time classes. Classes are definitely in person, online. Even if you're struggling and you just, you know, feel like you need a little more help, all of the professors are great with, you know, being there, having after hours, and you're able to go to tutoring. And even if you decide to join an organization around campus, there are always some people that you can buddy up with and, you know, talk to them about some of the courses that you're, you know, might need some help with or just need advice. So definitely reach out to anyone that you know that will definitely help you, and they will be sure to get you with the right people and connected in that kind of way.
And I think that just speaks personally to the faculty and staff that we have here at Central Piedmont. Our number one mission is being student focused. So anytime a student comes to any of us with an issue, with a problem, our goal is to try to provide some type of solution for that. So whether that be financially, whether that be time, transportation, hungry, anything that is going on with a student, we're looking for ways around the college to make sure that we can fill those gaps.
And yet again, the application process don't be intimidated by we have quite a few steps, but it's very, very easy to get everything going. You can finish your application in a day and just get the ball rolling. So again, you complete your residency, then you do the application. And then from there, you're creating your student account, you're setting up your orientation. Your orientation, you can complete that online or in person. You're setting up your academic advising appointment. event. And even right now we have these, we have Navigate Your Future, which is a wonderful event that will allow students to come in and get everything done same day, register, pay for your classes, get information on scholarships, financial aid. And a lot of the times, if you just go to our website, it's easy to navigate. You could just go on, look at the, type in the program that you're interested in. And a lot of the times we have information sessions that are virtual or information sessions that you can attend where you could just simply get the information. So again, our application is free. And a lot of the times, a lot of our recruiters, we just want to simply talk to you. We're not pushing you to do anything it is that you don't want to do. But again, you have options. You could be a part-time student or you could be a full-time student. It's totally up to you.
Now, before we get out of here, for anyone who's watching or anyone who's listening, do you all have any advice? It might be a person out there who's thinking about coming back and furthering their education, or they're thinking to themselves, I want to do it, but I don't know how. I don't know where to get started. I don't know how to get started. Do you have any advice for that person who's listening right now? You can look dead in the camera and give that advice to that person.
I think I would definitely say just to do it. Very Nike. Just do it. The biggest thing is getting started. And if you're thinking about it constantly, you're going to find ways to either talk yourself out of it, come up with excuses, when you could possibly just go ahead and fill out the application really quick, fill out the scholarship application really quick, put your information in so that we can contact you. And then you don't even have to worry about anything else. We're going to help guide you through the next steps. So I would say just getting started is the hardest part. Jump in there, just do it. And then let us be around to kind of help guide you and take you through the process.
Just to piggyback off of what Desiree said, you have to think about the end in mind. Where do you want to be? Because a lot of the times you think about it like, oh, it's already the end of the year, you know, and just think about, I could have started. And so let's change, change that could have, change your vocabulary. Give yourself an opportunity to look at a calendar and put a start date down, set some short-term goals and say, okay, this week I'm going to do some research. Next week, I'm going to attend an information session. The following week, I'm going to go ahead and do one application. After that, I'm going to, you know, make it an opportunity to, I always talk to my students about this, and even us as professionals, build some social capital, meaning build that team of people that you're going to know that's going to make you, that's going to really push you. So you have to build people. You have to be able to put people in your group that are going to encourage you, that have already maybe successfully done that. So you have to just really take a step back and think about the end in mind and set some goals.
And I'm a Charlotte native, so I have watched Central Piedmont change and grow, and I'm watching our city grow as well. So I, you know, had been in my industry for a long time, decided to further my career, and there's so many people from different ranges here, from high school students to people like myself, or people that are literally retiring and deciding to change their career altogether. But it's a great place here, whatever step you're at.
Right, like Des said, you just have to do it. Because I was actually hesitant at first because I was like, do I want to go to a four-year college and be in debt, or do I kind of just want to start off at a two-year college with a scholarship, you know, doing the better way? So, you know, in the end, I'm very, very thankful that I started out at a community college. Now I can transfer over to a four-year, and I'm now not going to be in too much debt, still a little bit, whatever, but it's worth it for the experience. But yeah, you just have to get out there. You have to be willing to get out your comfort zone, and you will definitely meet some amazing people. Like, I kid you not, since I've been at Central Piedmont, I've met so many great people. I've been able to get into the community and just be involved in so much, great friends, professors, different organizations. So all in all, it's definitely worth it. Thank you.
You got a career in some type of media. I don't know what it is, but you going places. But thank you. Thank you, Maney. Thank you. Thank you to everyone here today. Thank y'all for joining us. That'll do it here for Campus Convo at Central Piedmont. See what I did there?
You got this. It's never too late.